sleep apnea is a very common condition. In the adult population, it might be anywhere from 10 to 15% of the population that can have this condition. But basically, at its core, it's a breathing problem that occurs with sleep. When the brain goes to sleep at night, the airway muscles relax, and that allows the airway to narrow down. So basically, at nighttime, the upper airway is like a cylinder back behind the tongue. And so when your muscles relax at night, that airway relaxes as well. And so then you might start to have a little snoring. But eventually what happens is that airway will collapse. And at that point, the person's suffocating. They don't know it. Their brain starts to know it. And within about 10 seconds, the brain will wake up and open the airway up. And despite the fact that that sounds dramatic, people don't know that this is happening all night long. And so it does two things. It really diminishes the sleep quality a person achieves. So they can get 8 hours of sleep, but they never feel rested. But then also it might put a lot of extra stress on the body. So we know that it can affect the blood pressure, the heart, the brain. And these are chronic long-term exposures that we want to try to rectify. The basic definition of insomnia really is that a person can't sleep well and that there's a daytime consequence. Could be the person's irritable, they're tired, they're fatigued, they can't think right. So there's a really negative consequence to that bad night of sleep. Most adults have had a bad night of sleep before. Fortunately, most of us get right through it and the next night we're back on track. But some people, they develop really a chronic problem where they're just nightly not getting a good night of sleep. And so we really work to try to undo that for people. Sleep apnea is really diagnosed by doing a sleep study. And there are a couple different ways to do that, depending on the person's clinical scenario and their issues. Sometimes we'll bring them to the sleep center and do an overnight sleep test where they sleep overnight with our technicians and our staff at the center. Sometimes we can do this at home, which is a nice newer avenue for us to treat or diagnose sleep apnea. And that's a little bit simpler. We don't get the same amount of quality data, but it's still a quite useful test that we can do. Insomnia, really, there is no definitive diagnostic test for. It's really a clinical diagnosis made with a clinician, and we try to characterize that and define that in terms of how long has a person been suffering, what are the critical components to it, what are the underlying factors, what are the other conditions, whether it's chronic pain, different medications, other illnesses that might contribute. And so we really need that information to formulate a plan of action for that patient. My personal philosophy and approach with sleep is that it's so critical for every component of our health, either our daytime function or just even our brains and our hearts and every other organ system in our body. And because we don't know what's going on when we're asleep, it's really important, if you have any concern at all, to look into it. Because why would you ever want to live life with bad sleep if you could do otherwise? It's fundamental to our function, our alertness, our mood, and our well-being. And so, to me, it's really important to make an informed decision about my own health. And so I try to encourage people to do the same, that you should be proactive, learn about your sleep, learn about what could be different. Because if you have a problem, it's probably not going away until it's addressed. And sleep is a little bit unusual because you really don't necessarily know what's going on at night. And so here's the opportunity to change that.